go. Last day of bowl season has come to an end about 5 to 10 minutes ago as of the time of this recording. The Orange Bowl is now over. Safe to say that A&M maybe, just maybe, have planted their stamp. They have sent their grievances to the College Football Playoff Committee and got a big win against a North Carolina team down for All-Americans. Now, again, A&M had players injured and opted out as well, so we're not going to play that game. But it was a damn good game for most of it, you know, until the very, very end when A&M had to get that last touchdown, you know, to make it a 14-point game. But Devon Akane, you know, he really shined this game. You know, again, there are all sorts of storylines circulating with the A&M program. Could Kellen Mond come back? Because, you know, again, mostly everybody has an extra year of eligibility. So A&M could have Kellen Mond back. I think the big question for the Aggies is that can they overcome the hump that is Alabama? Now, Alabama lost someone today to my Texas Longhorns. Oh boy. Now this could get real interesting with Steve Sarkisian, who was once the head coach at Washington, once was the head coach at USC, now getting the Texas job. Tom Herman is gone. Finally. You know, despite the man going 4-0 in bowl games, you know, he just underperformed with the talent that he had. And if Steve Sarkisian can get guys like, you know, Tua Tagovailoa and Jalen Hurts to be, you know, efficient passers, you know, like that, like magic, you know, there could be some good things brewing for the Longhorns next season. Now, again, we don't know what in the world's going to happen. We don't know what in the world's going to happen. But, you know, Sarkisian has been revitalized under Saban and has just given us some, honestly, some great offenses that we've seen over the past 2 years. It's just some great offense by Alabama. It's been some damn good stuff. So what about the other bowl games today? You know, there was the Outback Bowl and the Gator Bowl early on that afternoon. Of course, there was some college basketball on as well that I decided to watch instead. But we'll talk about college basketball probably Monday. But, yeah. As far as the Gator Bowl and the Outback Bowls go to make up for Auburn, you know, getting blasted by Northwestern in the Citrus Bowl, two teams that were under 500 in Kentucky taking on NC State in the Gator Bowl and Indiana taking on Ole Miss in the Outback Bowl decided to, you know, step up and say, hey, that SEC, you know, that SEC elitism ain't going away. And surprisingly enough, Kentucky dominated NC State for most of that game, you know, until, you know, the very, very end. And Ole Miss, you know, just beat up on Indiana. Yeah, Indiana didn't have Michael Penix. They had Jack Tuttle at the quarterback position. And then I believe they had somebody else later on in that game. I'm not sure. I didn't watch that game, so I don't know. But, you know, big time wins. This is just rather disappointing for Indiana. This is 2 years in a row now that the season has ended. We were supposed to get 9 Windiana, you know, last year. And we didn't get that. We were supposed to get an Indiana that could, you know, potentially go to the College Football Playoff this year if they beat Ohio State, you know. They could have potentially gone to the Big Ten Championship if the Big Ten didn't screw them, you know, and just stuck with their rules. But, hey. You know, it is what it is. You know, it's nothing. It's nothing, you know, now that Indiana has done that again, you know, kind of sucks. And keeping with, you know, teams in the Big 12, keeping up with teams that want more, they want more success, how about those Iowa State Cyclones, baby? Matt Campbell has really got it going on down there. Brock Purdy, Breece Hall, and that defense just smothered Oregon for most of that game. I mean, there were so many plays in the Fiesta Bowl that just were astounding. You you know, the pop-up kick that ended up getting recovered by Iowa State was great. I mean, defensive plays were being made. You know, Oregon had to switch quarterbacks twice. You know, they had to switch between Brown and Shaw, but neither of them could get anything going. And Iowa State just did what they needed to do. Ball control, ball control, ball control. Same thing that A&M did. Ball control, ball control, ball control. And, you know, Iowa State, they have to keep this momentum up. If they want that Big 12 championship, I think they have to keep this momentum up. They have to keep this up. Matt Campbell's doing a great job out there. In fact, he's like, what, the, you know, he has the highest winning percentage of any Iowa State head coach. So he's got to keep this up. He's got to keep this momentum up. And, you know, if he can pull some guys in Iowa State, into Cyclone Country, things are looking pretty interesting at the Big 12. And, you know, next year, maybe the Big 12 could send somebody to the playoffs, you know? 2021, there's a perfect opportunity right there for this conference to send someone to the playoffs for the first time in a couple of years, you know, that isn't Oklahoma, you know, anyway. Could be, you know. And as far as the SEC goes, you know, I think everything is going, you know, just the way we expected. It's Alabama or, you know, whoever gets hot at the right time like Auburn did, you know, a couple years back, or LSU last year with Joe Burrow, or, you know, Florida with Tebow. You know, whoever gets hot in this conference that puts Alabama off to the side for a year or two, you know, is also good. Could it be A&M? Could it be A&M next year? We don't know that yet. We'll find that out, you know, soon as we go through the long, treacherous offseason, not knowing what's to come with Corona Chan. But yeah, so there you have it. January 2nd, 2021. Bowl season is over. Bowl season was a lot of fun. I watched a very select few bowl games from, you know, the seconds from that Saturday, you know, that last Saturday with the Coastal Carolina Chanticleers and Liberty and all that stuff, you know, with the First Responder Bowl too. And then there was Brawls, there was the Liberty Bowl with the Army Black Knights. There was just so many storylines this bowl season that gave us a lot of things and a lot of potential for what was to come. And now we focus on one game. There is one game left in the season instead of two, because the FCS decided to, you know, push their seats to the spring. But there's one game left, and that is the national championship, the college football playoff national championship, big time underdog, Ohio State, mega power in Alabama with many storylines surrounding them, especially with Steve leaving. You know, he's not leaving till after the championship, but there's a big storyline with him going on right now, you know, now that he's going to Texas. And there's a lot going in. So the next college football, you know, preview, recap, whatever, you know, the next thing that I'll talk about will be my, what I'm thinking about this national championship, what I'm thinking is going to happen in this Natty that we're going to have on January the 11th. So I'll see you for that video very, very soon, later on in the week, and NFL tomorrow, like late tomorrow. So, you know, there's that. And then college football stuff on Monday. I mean, not college football stuff, college basketball stuff on Monday. So I'll see you guys tomorrow night after Sunday Night Football. Peace.